like to get this call at this time of the season to provide some help?
I mean, you know, it's always good. I love playing football. I want to play football. So when I got the call, only thing on my mind was I get opportunity to go out there and do what I love to do. You know, no matter how long it took, I was ready to go.
How important is the veteran savvy that this team may need with some of the key injuries in the secondary?
It's very important. It's very important. I mean, when you got guys out there that's been around for a while, they know what's going to happen before it happens. You know, especially when we're in the meeting room and doing our study, and we can help out the younger guys also. So I think it's real good to have a few good vets around, because when things start to get a little rocky and get a little shaky in the game, they can calm some of the younger guys down around them and just help them focus in on what they need to do.
You got a history with Coach Chamberlain or Coach Missick? If so, can you explain what it means?
I don't have a history with Coach Chamberlain. When he went to Hamilton, I left Hamilton to go to Calgary, and I was in Calgary with Coach Missick. He was my DB coach there, so I have a little bit of history with him. I know what he expects of me, and I know exactly what he wants me to do.
What do you try to offer when you get a call like this? What do you try to bring to this team?
What I do best is playing man coverage. That's all. I mean, you know, that's what they wanted me to come here and do, and that's what I like to do, and that's what I'm bringing.
How much of an adjustment are the new rules then for a guy that's been doing it a different way for a while?
I mean, you know, it's a little adjustment. I mean, it's new things. It's going to always be a little adjustment, but it's all about being a pro. You figure out how to get it done, and you figure out how to get it done fast.
Was ever a worry that you weren't going to get that call, or you knew it was just a matter of time? What was running through your mind while you were kind of, the days were going by?
You know, to be honest with you, I thought in my mind, I believed I was going to get picked up. You know, you got to be real about it at some point, and anything could happen, you know. But in my mind, I know the type of player that I am. I know how I prepare, and I know what I've been doing for the past 7 years. So I can say I didn't have a doubt that I wasn't going to get picked up. I knew I was. It was just a matter of when.
Quick, bringing in Geoff Tisdale. Mm-hmm. How familiar are you with him, clearly from Montreal, and what does he bring to the table?
Well, I think first of all, he's an established veteran who makes plays, so he's a playmaker. And, you know, coming from Montreal, I was impressed with what he had done there. And obviously, Brendan and Corey and J.O. and everybody has seen the same things from him. And we felt like the need with the injuries we had in the back end, to bring in a veteran player that's got a little swag about him, got a little confidence, and we can expect, we know what we can expect from him. And so I think he'll give a little solidarity to the back end of what's happening now. And so we're excited about having him.
With an injury to a leader like Weldon Brown, how important was it to get a veteran in there to replace?
Well, you know, I that's what I appreciate about this organization, is they don't only recognize the profit margin, but they also understand to get that profit margin, you know, we've got to do something to make sure we establish a certain level of talent on our field. You lose a player like Weldon, he can't be replaced by any means, because he's an integral part of what we do. His leadership, his personality, all that in the room is so important. But on the field, you needed to replace that confidence, that leadership, and you needed a plug-and-play player, and Geoff provided that for us.